من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله، النبي المبعوث رحمة للعالمين، بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة، فرفع الله به الغمة، وجاهد في الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين، صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. الحمد لله الذي ضمن الرزق للمؤمن والكافر، الحمد لله الذي يعطي الدنيا من يحب ومن لا يحب، ولا يعطي الدين إلا لمن أحب، جمع شملنا ولما فرقتنا، فله الحمد حمدا طيبا مباركا فيه. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. ثم أما بعد، فإن خير الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وأن شر الأمور محدثاتها، وأن كل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. إن شاء الله today we'll continue with الاستغفار. قال الله تعالى في سورة النساء: واستغفر الله إن الله كان غفورا رحيما. And seek forgiveness of Allah, for Allah is oft forgiving, most merciful. وقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم: من لزم الاستغفار جعل الله له من كل ضيق مخرجا ومن كل هم فرجا وارزقه من حيث لا يحتسب. رسول الله said: if anyone constantly seeks Allah forgiveness, Allah appoint for him a way out of every distress and a relief from all his concern, and will provide for him when he did it from a way which he didn't consider. الحسن البصري قال: لا أظن أن الله يعذب رجلا استغفر. الحسن البصري said: I don't think that Allah will punish one of his slaves if he make استغفار. فقيل له: لماذا يا إمام؟ فقال: من ألهمه الاستغفار؟ So they told him, or they asked him why. Then he said, who remind him to make استغفار? So the people asking him, they said, Allah. So then he said, كيف يلهمه الله الاستغفار ويريد به أذن. So how Allah inspired him to make استغفار while he want to punish him. And then he read من سورة الأنفال: وما كان الله معذبهم وهم يستغفرون. And Allah will not punish them while they were praying for forgiveness. My dear sister and brother, listen to what Uthman ibn Affan said. Wallahi, what he said is very important. قال عثمان بن عفان: قرأت القرآن من أوله إلى آخره، فلم أرى أي آية أحسن وأرجى من قوله تعالى في سورة الحج: نبئ عبادي أني أنا الغفور الرحيم. Uthman said, I read the Quran from the beginning to the end. And the best ayah with hope was, tell my servant that I am indeed the oft forgiving, most merciful. You see, Uthman ibn Affan, from the 10 Ushjawir Mubashareen, then he's going to Jannah. What he said, that this is the best ayah which make him relax, that Allah promised, that nabbis means that tell my slave that I am the one which is really forgiven. Listen to this story. Bani Israel, the people of Israel, they were lost in the desert for almost 40 years. And then the rain stopped to come down and they were very thirsty. They cannot cultivate, they cannot do anything. So Sayyidina Musa asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, O Allah, why the rain is not coming down? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala awha lahu. Allah sent Jibreel to tell him, there is a man among Bani Israel, which he disobey me for 40 years and he never asked for forgiveness. So the rain will not come down until he asked me for forgiveness. So Musa stand, Sayyidina Musa, قال لبني إسرائيل إن بينكم رجل يعصي الله وإن لم يسأل الله المغفرة فإن الله لن ينزل المطر. So Musa, سيدنا موسى said to بني إسرائيل, O people of Israel, there is among us a man which he disobey Allah for 40 years and he never ask Allah for forgiveness. So Allah will not let rain come down until this man came and then ask Allah for forgiveness. And then he was waiting for somebody to come to the front and say, okay, I am the one which I disobey Allah and then I ask Allah to forgive me. So the rain start, he stay and stay. Nobody come to see that. Suddenly, فجأةً, نزل المطر. فقال موسى يا ربي لم يتقدم أحد من بني إسرائيل على إنه الرجل الذي يعصي الله. فقال الله سبحانه وتعالى إن هذا الشخص this man already asked for forgiveness. إن هذا الرجل سألني أن أغفر له. فسأله موسى Can you tell me who is this person? يا الله هل من الممكن أن أعلم من هو الشخص؟ فقال الله سبحانه وتعالى إني دريت على هذا الشخص I covered this person for more than 40 years so I'm not going to tell you now who is he. And how this happened? The person when he was standing among Bani Israel he said Oh Allah I'm shy to what I did, so please don't let me expose myself and say what I did in front of Bani Israel. So this is showing that even the rain to come down, so the people, they have to admit their mistake. They have to ask Allah for forgiveness. They have to know that when you ask Allah for forgiveness, as Rasulullah said, He will make for you from every distress a relief. The second story, it was about Imam Ahmad. Imam Ahmad was traveling and he came at night and he didn't find any place to sleep, to spend the night. So what he did? He found the first masjid and he went to the masjid, he prayed Isha and then he tried to sleep in one of the corner of the masjid. So the guy who was taking care of the masjid came and told him, you cannot sleep in the masjid. You have to go out. Nobody can sleep here. Then he told him, I don't have any place to sleep. And let me sleep tonight. I said, no. Of course, Imam Ahmad didn't tell him, I am so and so. So the man dragged him outside of the masjid. After he dragged him and closed the door, Imam Ahmad was sitting on the stairs of the masjid. So a man was passing by and then he asked him, why you stay like that? He told him, I don't have a place to sleep tonight and, you know, the guy did so and so with me. Then he told him, I can take you to my shop and then you can sleep there. The guy was a baker. So Imam Ahmad went with him. And then this person or this slave, every time he do the dough or he put the stuff in the stove or he do any things, he say, Astaghfirullah. في كل الأوقات عندما يعجن العجين أو يخبز العجين فهو يذكر لا إله إلا الله Astaghfirullah. All night, same way. So Imam Ahmad asked him, Oh my brother, can you tell me Did you gain any things from your continuously ask Allah for forgiveness? هل الله لبى لك أي شيء من كثرة الاستغفار؟ فقال له: والله ما سألت الله شيئا إلا أعطاه لي. Then he told him, والله everything that I ask Allah, he give it to me. Except one thing, إلا شيء واحد. فقال له: وما هو؟ قال: سألت الله سبحانه وتعالى أن أرى الإمام أحمد قبل أن أموت، فلم أره حتى الآن. فبكى الإمام أحمد. The baker told Imam Ahmad, I ask Allah, only one wish I didn't come through. I ask Allah that I want to see Imam Ahmad, but until now I didn't see him. So Imam Ahmad cried and say, whatever you ask Allah, Allah drag me to your baker. Allah also accept what you said, accept your istighfar, and bring me to your baker, so your wish was fulfilled. So this again another example, my dear sister, brother, then how al-istighfar is good. And again we have to remember what Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu qala. It was two things on earth make us safe from the punishment of Allah. One of them was Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam وَقَدْ صَعَدَتْ رَوْحَهُ لِلسَّمَاءِ. And then Rasulullah, and then he died. وَالثَّانِيَ هُوَ الْإِسْتِغْفَارِ. And Allah lifted the istighfar with us. This why in Surah Al-Anfal, قَالَ اللَّهُ مَا كَانَ اللَّهُ مُعَذِّبَهُمْ وَهُمْ يَسْتَغْفِرُونَ. So remember, inshallah, my dear sister and brother, al-istighfar, forgiveness, ask Allah forgiveness every time, day and night, in your work, in your table, and you're anywhere walking, driving, and teach your children, teach your family that doing a lot of istighfar, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will protect everyone and then will give you what you want, inshallah. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.